Ready?
Ready. Go for it.
Well, hello again, everybody. The next car that you selected to view on ClassicMuscleCars.com is another new arrival in our showroom. But before I tell you about this car, I just want to thank everybody for coming to ClassicMuscleCars.com in the year 2004. Looking at our stats, we've had over 1 million people that came to ClassicMuscleCars.com in the year 2004. Thanks to everybody. Thanks to all the people that's watched our videos day in and day out. You've made us one of the most popular internet sites on the internet for collector cars and classic muscle cars. So thanks to everybody, and keep watching, right, Jeremy? Now, this car is a car that we just got finished with. We got a couple things that I still have to do, and I'm going to tell you what we're going to finish on it, but it is a gorgeous car. It's a 69 Camaro X55 code, which the code means it's original Supersport. Now, it's not a numbers car throughout. It's got a ZZ4 GM crate motor. I'll tell you about that in a second, but I want to tell you what we had to do to this car. Before we started anything in this car, there was $30,000 invested. This is a real high-quality car, but it wasn't the way that I wanted it. It didn't look right. Remember, we've talked about the things that we do here. We change things to make them the way that they should be, or the way that we like them, or the way that I personally like them. What had happened was they tried to do an older-style stripe that you don't see too much on a 69 Camaro. And that stripe ran down the hood and on the top of the header panel, and it curves and goes over the fender. It should be higher on the top of the fender like the stripe that we have on it now, which is a hockey stripe. But what they had did with this car when they painted it, they brought it down and ran it right into the wheel well and on the seam right above where the emblems are. And Jeremy, you can probably show them on the other side where it says Camaro. Anyway, it's way too low. It was, the white was right into the chrome molding, basically, on the wheel well. Didn't look right at all. Looked more like a 68, and it was not the way that it should be. Now, they had done a great job because they clear coated it. You couldn't even feel the stripe on it, but it wasn't right, and I didn't like it at all. I liked the car because the car was a quality car, and I wanted to get this car, and I wanted to take it and redo it the way that it should be. So that's what we did. Now, it's not an easy thing removing stripes like that because we virtually had to repaint this whole car, everything except for the roof, where we blended back in, because you have to strip all of that off. You have to wind up painting, but you can't just paint the parts because you got to make everything blend and match. So we basically did the whole car again and blended it back into the roof. And the car is just gorgeous. It's been wet sand and buffed to perfection. It has a lot of clear coat on it. It's just a gorgeous, gorgeous car. The color is a dark blue metallic. This was a popular color back in 1969. You didn't see too many of these cars with this color because they had a lighter shade of blue, or you would probably recognize the color Le Mans blue, which is a lighter blue with metallic in it. But this is a very dark blue, and it is a factory GM color. Now, we got the white hockey stripes on it. We put it on this the way they should look, and they look awesome on this car. It really sets this car off. The engine, again, is a brand new ZZ4 GM crate motor. Now, you see a lot of these crate motors being put in street rods or street cars that need engines, or they don't have the original engine, and you want to put a hot motor in a car like this that you can still run on pump gas, and it's dependable. This has aluminum heads. They have a three-angle valve job and angle heads on it. This also has aluminum heads, and it's a four-bolt main block. It's 355 horsepower at 5,200 RPM, and it has 405 pounds of torque. So it's a great engine combination here. It's a very durable motor. You can take the car out and drive it all day long, and you can stand on it at every stoplight or street corner that you want to, and it'll do what it's supposed to do. It's putting its power into a turbo 350 trans, and that's been tricked out a little bit. It's got a shift kit, and it goes right back out to a 12-bolt 373 posi in the back. So the car is a very quick street car. You can run it on any pump gas you can find anywhere, and you can take it out in 100 degree days, and you're not going to have a problem with it overheating, anything like that. So it's a great street car. Now, beside the beautiful paint that's on the car that we just finished and got it the way that we wanted it, the car's quality throughout. It has new carpeting in it. The seat covers, door panels, side panels, and back seat, and headliner, and crash pad has all been redone in the car. It's just beautiful on the inside. All the soft seal, which is the weather stripping, that's all been replaced also. It has a steel cowl hood on it. Windshield's been replaced. The rest of the glass in the car is excellent condition. The mirrors, the wheelhouse moldings, the emblems, the bumpers, it's all been redone. Trim rings, center caps on the wheels, they've been restored. They're new. Tires are new. Exhaust is new. Brakes, shocks, suspension, pretty much everything in the car has been completely gone through. This is what we call a low-maintenance car, because you're not having to get into the car and do repairs and repairs and repairs, because that's kind of common with an older car. This car has been gone through to the point to where it's wash, wax, and maintain it. Take it into Jiffy Lube, change oils, that sort of thing. And just use a great spray wax on it. I wouldn't want to see you going into it with, I don't like hand waxes on these kind of cars, especially the darker colors, because if you make a mistake and you take this car, wax it outside in the sunlight, you're going to have a lot of problem getting the wax off, and it's never going to have this kind of finish again unless you buff it again. So what I recommend with all of the cars that we do here and the way that we prep them so that you get this gloss look is to use a spray wax on them, and it'll keep them looking like this, and you're not going to get wax in the cracks and crevices of the cars, which you probably know what I'm talking about. If you've seen somebody use the old paste type wax, you'll see it in all the cracks and grooves, and it's just absolutely disgusting. I hate that when I see it. It's something that people should never do. So remember, spray wax, that's the best thing to do, and especially on base coat, clear coat, a very durable paint. That's all you need when they're brought up to this kind of finish. That's all you have to do to keep and maintain this, and this car can look like this for the next 10 years. So that's the great thing. Back in the day when these cars were built, they were lacquer paint. They're not very durable. It was very hard to get this kind of a luster and shine out of it, and it's only the new stage base coat, clear coat paints that you can work to get this kind of a beautiful finish. Now, when Jeremy shows you this car, it's super straight down the side. It's got a spoiler on it. It's really got a hot look to it. It sets itself apart from a lot of the other Camaros that are out there. It's just been done with that kind of taste in mind to make it different than the other ones. Also, we were going to tell you about the interior on it. There was a couple things that I wanted to do. The steering wheel, Jeremy can show you. It's brand new. I don't like it. It's more vintage, kind of 60s style for a custom wheel that you would have seen Kyle Custom sell back in the 60s, that type of wheel. We're going to take that out, and we're going to put a simulated wood wheel in it, and then we're going to change the shifter. It's got a Hurst quarter stick in it. I don't like that. I'm going to put a shifter back in it that looks more vintage. It's going to look like a four-speed shifter with a boot on it, but it's still for the automatic, and it's going to have a real quick, crisp shift when you hit the hammer on it. So it's really going to look awesome on the car. Dash panel up here too. This is just in beautiful condition. A lot of times these Camaros, this is a metal panel up here. In 69, there was a lot of problems with these cars because the way the windshield went in and the way this panel came up and dropped down, there's just a little area here that wasn't sealed off with caulking, and that used to get a lot of condensation in it. No matter where you were, any part of the country, unless it was 80 degrees and in the desert every day, anything that ever got any condensation up here caused this panel to rust out. So this has all been redone. There's no issues here. It's just in beautiful condition. Windshield was put in new, and it was all resealed. You won't have any problems with this. Today, the way we take care of cars, it's not like you're going to leave it outside and let the weather get at it, so there won't be any issues. The windshield chrome up here, this has all been replaced, antennas new. Everything on this car is just in gorgeous shape. When you look at the hood, you look at the doors, and Jeremy will show you when you come around, and the trunk has a beautiful fit and finish. It's just got a far superior body to a lot of the Camaros that I see. They may all be nice, but this is more of a show car. This is a car that has had a lot of time and effort put into it for the restoration to get it to the condition that it's in. So if you're a real picky guy, you're going to come out and look at this car, and you're going to really like what you see. It's done really nice under the hood. Jeremy's going to show you that. The firewall and the wheel wells have been painted the same color as the car. So that really sets it off. It looks awesome. It's something that you're really going to like. If you can't come out to see this car in person, give Ed a call at 847-526-5950. He will give you any information you want, and he'll also let you see any pictures that you ask for him to take, he'll do for you. So now I'm going to turn you over to Jeremy. He's going to take you for a go around and a walk around of this beautiful 1969 SS X55 code Camaro.
Hi there, and now that we're at it, we're going to take a little time starting out under the hood. See what a fine detail job they've done in here. Nice set of Edelbrock valve covers. Nice job on the headers as well. Outstanding. While we're here, you can get a look at this excellent paint job on this car. Oh, a little bright there. It is 10 feet deep. This car is super straight. Nice job on that stripe here. What he was talking about before was that stripe came all the way along here and went along this line right here. And it was thick, wide, and not exactly the way he likes it. So this is what you have now. Much better. Correct. And there I am. Sorry about the hot spots there on the lights. One day we will have diffusers. Let's get a shot of our Kramer collection as reflected in the hood of the car. And there's the Kramer collection on the wall, or part of it anyway. Beautiful. Let's check out inside. I think we can lose the mat, protect the paper. Let's look in the back seat. Let's put a little night shot on here. Immaculate. And in front. What is it? 22034 on the odometer. We got the Super Sun Tech on the collar underneath here. Night shot, so we can see it's so bright. There we are. It's these are Sun Pro, and there's the water temperature, the voltmeter, and oil pressure gauge. And above this, we have a Panasonic in-dash cassette. And let's lose the night shot here. There's the Hurst quarter stick. I'm not a big fan of these things, but it's there for now, but not for long, because Tony said it's on its way out. Looking at the rest of the interior, it's unremarkable. It's also nice and clean. Put the night shot on there so we can see a little better what's cooking underneath. No, it's not green, it's really black, but that's the way it looks with night shot on. No console. Okay, let's check out the trunk. We'll grab the keys and head on back. Inside, as you can see, is immaculate, beautiful, clean. Wait, there's a fuzzy there. Someone left it in the trunk. Probably from a buffing wheel or something. Nice and clean. Let's do a night shot. Looking nice. Looks like a fresh soft seal. Beautiful. All right. One last thing here. Tony mentioned that he was going to be changing out this wheel. It does look a whole lot like a Cal custom wheel from the 60s and 70s. It's going away. You get a rosewood wheel. Well, that's the story on this car. Beautiful 1969 Camaro SS X55 code, dark blue with a 10-foot thick paint job, waiting to go home with you.